Shout out to my guys with Proton Pass. Looks like that's pretty heavy.
No question, right?
All right, so yes, my name is David Gordon. I work with Lion Force Comics. I'm the assistant editor. And what we're going to be doing today is we're actually going to be presenting on creating comics and really kind of getting the audience involved in the presentation as well. So kind of sit back, relax, we're going to have some fun. And assisting me today is going to be Lorenzo Lozada, and I'll let him introduce himself. Don't say anything.
I'm Lorenzo Lozada, former art director at Lion Forge, but I'm also one of the artists, and I'm a creator. I create my own comics, and I've been doing it for the past 20 years.
Yeah, a long time. All right, so basically, what do? When we create comics, so when you're thinking about comic book creators, what comes to mind? Anybody? Hands.
Script.
And anybody else?
Storyboards.
Plotting.
Character.
Yeah, character development.
Character development. In the back.
Panels in general.
And yes. Lots of inking, yes, yes.
Lots of sitting and drawing for hours and hours and hours.
It's not, okay, it is that bad, but it's very rewarding at the end, correct?
Yes.
All right. And everything that everybody brought up is an excellent point. The main thing that I would, the one thing I want everybody to take away from that is that comic book creators, we are storytellers, we're visual storytellers. Our job at the end of the day is to convey a thought process, a point to the audience, correct? Sounds good, right? Yeah. So what we're going to do today is that we're going to create a story. Well, and when I say we, I mean you guys are going to do all the work.
Yeah.
We're just going to facilitate this. Well, he's going to work. I'm going to do a lot of talking and pointing. I get the fun job today. Normally I'm sitting at the desk.
That's what he thinks.
This
is the fun part, throw it.
Well, it is. So, all right. So, last year what we did is that we basically spoke to a large group of kids. They came up with this incredible, incredible story. So, the challenge today, you guys have to beat it. Now, you're going up against stiff competition. This was 8-year-olds. They had some stuff. They had some nice stuff. So, first part of creating a comic book, you got to come up with some characters. And we're going to just come up with two. So, let's come up with a character.
Octopus Man.
Octopus Man. Okay, so we're going to have Octopus Man and...
A Ninja Lemur.
Well, that's tricky.
Remember what I said about I had the easy part? See? So now, as Lorenzo draws Octopus Man, and he works his magic using his magic marker. Remember, 8. I think it's more than 8.
Oh, he's a feet.
Oh.
I can count.
I didn't say you couldn't count, but let's just make sure. All right, so now we've got Octopus Man. We're going to do a Ninja Lemur. So, got our two characters. Those are going to be our heroes. Heroes need villains. So, let's come up with some ideas for some villains. And remember, you're competing against 8-year-olds, so you guys got to really come up with something nice. Because what those guys came up with, it was pretty nice.
A toaster. Sushi chef.
A toaster, what else?
Sushi chef.
A toaster and a sushi chef. So we got a Ninja Lemur. We got Octopus Man. So there goes Octopus Man.
The toaster should be a pirate to balance the Ninja Lemur.
Toaster pirate.
His 8-year-old's a rainbow
now. Okay, so Ninja Lemur is next. Okay, we're going to do a female ninja lemur. We're going to make it even harder for Lorenzo.
That's not right.
So he says. All right, so we've got a ninja lemur, we've got a pirate toaster as a villain, and we've also got a crazy sushi chef. Okay, so all of our villains are normally motivated by something highbrow to take over, do whatever. So what's their motivation? What's their motivation?
Shortage of donuts.
A shortage of donuts. So they're going to create. So are they creating a shortage of donuts, or are they going crazy because there's a shortage of donuts?
They need to get natural resources to make more donuts.
They need to get natural resources to make more donuts. Remember, these are bad guys. So it's got to be nefarious. They have to have a nefarious. So
poison sprinkles.
Ah. Now we're working. Now we're cooking right here. So our guys are going to cause a shortage of donuts so that people have to use donuts for poison sprinkles. Poison sprinkles. All right, so this kind of ties things together real quick. This is actually kind of a collaborative effort. This is the story creating process. And while it's fun and slapstick and everything like that, this is actually kind of how we go through our brainstorm sessions, where we sit there and we talk amongst ourselves, and we just toss out ideas. And normally what happens is someone will say, well, that's the stupidest thing I've ever heard in my life. And we'll say, okay, let's go with it. And we'll see how we can
Let's work with it.
And why would you think that the stupidest idea in the world would be the one that we want to go with?
Pretty much.
But anybody, why would you think that we would go with that?
It's unique.
Yeah.
The most unique idea, yes. So think about it. If it's the same as everybody else, who's going to read it? But if you've got an octopus man, a ninja lemur, female,
well, you actually did pretty good.
I'll never doubt you.
Shocking. Yes, you do.
Hmm? Oh, yeah, gotta have a tail. Gotta make sure she has a tail. There you go. Now remember, we got pirate toaster and crazy sushi chef.
Pirate toaster.
So.
Next one.
Let's see how he handles this one, folks.
You're already dead.
Good one. All right, so Lorenzo draws our pirate toaster and our great sushi chef, and we now have the motivation for our villains. We now have to kind of come up with a story for our heroes and our villains, and how we're going to bring them together for their epic clash, correct? Sounds good. So, first off, let's start with our heroes. Where are our heroes at right now?
The ninja lemur and her secret identity is a baker. So that's how she comes across the poison sprinkles.
Ah,
she's a baker. That makes sense.
Hold on, wait a minute. I have a comment about the toaster. And it's a good one.
So the lemur makes the donuts?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. She's one of many donut makers in this town.
Oh, time to make the donuts.
Time to make the donuts. She's got a good sprinkle, it's not a bad sprinkle.
Oh.
So these are the good sprinkle donuts that she's got. Alright, so now going back to your toaster for a second. Don't you look like Plankton? Reminds me of Plankton. That's actually a good idea. Alright, so we know that our ninja lemur is actually going to discover this sinister plot to poison the donuts with poison sprinkles.
What's that?
You know what? That's a good idea. And you know why? Because any good villain, they don't want to poison well except for the Joker. Most villains, they want to control people for whatever reason. They like to be in control. They're control freaks. We'll leave it at that. Alright, so they're mind-altering sprinkles that are going to control people. Now you gotta do your sushi chef, sir.
Sushi chef?
Yes, praise sushi chef. Now, looking at our two villains, whom would you think is the mastermind of this diabolical plot?
Well,
The toaster.
The toaster.
The toaster.
Yeah.
Yeah. You wouldn't expect something that's not bothering from the sushi chef, would you?
But he gets a little hot-headed.
He gets a little hot-headed. So our sushi chef has anger management issues. He's a very angry sushi chef. I wish it would explain why he's turned to villainy and crime. And has decided to try to take over the world.
He really wants to be a donut maker. We got stuck in the family tree of making.
Wow. Hey, that's great. So, he was going to be a donut maker.
He wants to break out of the stereotype.
He doesn't want to be a sushi chef anymore. He likes enjoying sushi.
I decided that he'll be a piece of sushi. That'll be his head.
This right here.
Every now and then, false Cartoon Network loads.
We're not mad at you about this. I just wanted to clarify that he now looks like sushi. Of course, he has cleavers. All right, so our sushi chef wants to get out of his life of being a sushi chef maker, and he wants to be a baker, but he can't, so now he's turned to a life of crime, and he's willing to help our pirate toaster take over the minds of all the innocent people. All right, so we need a setting for this story. Yes, ma'am?
I think it should be the donut shop, because the octopus likes to wear donuts, because he can eat them throughout the day.
Oh, yeah, we'll give him something to eat later on. I'll tell you right now, you guys are doing pretty good. You're giving those 8-year-olds a run for the money. They don't know what they were up against. I told you, I need my $5.
We need it.
Yes, we took a bit.
At the end, we'll tell you what they did.
It was quite interesting.
Yes, it was.
All right, so everything's going to take place at the donut shop that our ninja lemur in her alter identity, secret identity, works at. So, we're going to create a couple panels, and young Lorenzo here is going to ask you a couple panels. And
he said young, y'all heard him, right?
I did. I wanted to make him feel good for today. He's going to draw a sushi shop. Now, oh, I'm sorry, our donut shop. They can have a crazy sushi chef. All right, so we're at the sushi shop. Let's kind of think this out, or flesh this out, guys. We're at the sushi shop. How does our ninja lemur discover this diabolical plot?
Trail of donuts.
Now, what would make this trail of donuts so unique? Because just a trail of donuts, that could be, that could be me, just, I didn't have money, so I took it, snatched and grabbed.
There's the recipe book with the recipe book for the evil donuts.
Recipe book for the evil donuts, yes, sir.
It's just a trending topic on Twitter.
Trending topic, you know what? That actually works. That is so of the times. Okay, so we have a trending topic on Twitter.
Yeah.
Oh, this trail of donuts. Yes, ma'am. That actually makes more sense. Okay. But you know what? You can link the Twitter, so Twitter and Instagram. That's how we do it. Integration. Social media. So, our heroes have noticed that there are some interesting posts on Instagram and Twitter, correct? Is this our story so far? And that's what we're sticking to it, right? No changes.
I think then the octopus is curious enough to start eating the donuts, and the lemur girl discovers octopus man is all tripping out on
them. Donuts. Maybe they go to the donut shop because of what's posted on Instagram and Twitter, and because the octopus is eating so many donuts all at once, they start tripping out or doing whatever, and they're behaving differently, and the ninja lemur notices.
There we go. So we've got this. So
the Twitter, Instagram is the enticement.
Yes.
To go to
so Octopus Man is going to see the trending topic on Twitter and Instagram, goes to the donut shop, starts eating the donuts, right? Donuts are good. Octopus man, he needs his donuts in his life. He needs it in his life. And all of a sudden, he starts acting weird, and that's when our ninja lemur notices that the city's other superhero is out there and needs help.
The toaster.
Alright, so if the toaster's posting it, so why is it toaster's posting on Instagram, we know why he's posting on Instagram. How will this lead us, our hero, back to the toaster? Well, wait a minute. First off, I forgot, this is a superhero book, right? So what happens with superhero books?
Let them fight.
So, if Octopus Man is going crazy and Lima Girl notices, what's gonna happen?
They fight. Toaster guy left his GPS on, so he knows the location now, and then just goes to the location to scrap.
So he left his geotag on his Instagram post.
Technology.
That's every time. All right, so first things first, our heroes have to fight each other, of course, right?
The obligatory fight scene.
Standard team of fight. Then once she, so okay, during this fight, we're keeping your part. Don't worry, we're getting back to that. How does our ninja lemur break Octopus Man out of his trance?
Shot of adrenaline.
A super cappuccino
providing the shot of adrenaline that rakes him up. Good grief.
That's pretty good.
This is actually pretty good. I told you those 8-year-olds didn't stand a chance.
It's the new Starbucks unicorn drink.
It's like pink and purple. It's amazing. Oh, okay. So now that's what it is. So we put unicorns with everything now, and that makes it amazing.
Yes.
So the unicorn
was
amazing.
So terrifying.
That actually got terrifying comes to mind. All right, so she's going to have to give him a shot of cappuccino, and you know what? We're going to use the unicorn powered cappuccino because that's the strongest cappuccino ever, correct? All right. And as Lorenzo kind of draws those panels real quick. We want to keep going. So now, our fight's done. Octopus Man is back to himself. Our heroes are now trying to figure out what's going on, and they look at Instagram and Twitter to find the geotag, right? So why would he do that? Was he just not paying attention? Was he not thinking? So, every villain has a secret lair.
He's not a smart toaster.
He's a big box store. Margaritaville. So we have Margaritaville in a big box store, like a huge Best Buy or Walmart or something.
TJ Maxx.
TJ Maxx.
That's
what he's saying.
They'll never expect it.
All right, guys, you got to figure out which one's going to be. Is it going to be? All right, so here it is. We're going to take show of hands. Will it be the big box store, like TJ Maxx, Walmart? Will it be?
What was that?
What are the two options?
Well, it was
back
of Krispy Kreme,
wasn't
it? Right. Yeah. Waffle House. Or Waffle House. So, all right, so
there it is. Wow. There's no place scarier than Waffle House.
Okay, I think it's a consensus. The Waffle House it is. So, our villains are based out of a Waffle House. The scariest Waffle House ever created.
They make sushi there.
Waffle House that makes so is a sushi Waffle House. Oh, boy.
Waffle House and sushi together at last.
You know what? Strangely enough, somebody might be listening to this and like, waffles and sushi. Hey, waffles and sushi. But see here, I don't know about waffles and sushi. Okay, so, since Pirate Toaster is our master villain, most master villains have henchmen, something to throw at our superheroes to slow them down. What is he going to have besides his ultimate bad guy, crazy sushi guy?
Boomerang.
Boomerang people. Boomerang people and burnt toast. So, we're going to put this together. Our boomerang people throw burnt toast. But of course, it just can't be regular toast. What's so special about this burnt toast?
They're bagels. And they're bagels.
The burnt bagels. And. So they're just burnt. So that means they're like hard as rocks. The hardest rocks are like throwing stars. These are like the world's deadliest bagels and burnt toast. So our heroes are battling it out. Wow, that actually was easy.
Thank you for the contribution.
You know what, you think you might actually draw comics for a living. Who would have thought this?
I'm actually a doctor.
You're actually a doctor?
But I slept at a Holiday Inn.
You slept at a Holiday Inn. That makes sense. Alright, so this is our big battle scene. We've got toasters, we've got burnt toast, burnt bagels. They are so hard, so sharp, they can stick to your skin and then kill you. Our heroes are going to battle through. How are they going to fight through this barrage of deadliness?
The butter knife of glory.
The butter knife of glory. Any story that has the butter knife of glory is that's an Eisner Award winning story right there.
Lox gun?
Oh, what now?
Gun.
A lox gun and the butter knife of glory. There we go.
Don't forget the zap and how word effects.
Oh yeah, gotta have that.
So I'm gonna help Lorenzo here. So the next page should just be a splash page of our heroes revealing the butter knife of glory and the lox gun. And he's like screaming indoors. And that's when a ninja lemur shows up with the butter knife of glory. So this has to be the most glorious butter knife ever created.
And because of that, you know we have to do what they call in comics, force perspective.
Of course, it's got to be force perspective. Means it's going to look like it's coming right out at you. It's gonna be in 3D. Because this is not just any butter knife. This is the butter knife of glory. Alright, so you know what, with this curvy premise. Alright, so let's bring this crazy story to an end. With the butter knife of glory at their side, how do our heroes defeat our diabolical villains?
Well, for the food fair, she has to stick the butter knife in
the
thereby electrocuting herself and the toaster.
No,
she's
special forces. Right, oh, she's right. Has, she can survive.
Oh,
okay. Oh, she throws it in. So she's gonna throw it in the toaster. Which makes sense. She went next to it. Holding it. An octopus man eats the sushi head. Wow. What a way to go. All right, so that will actually conclude our story. So let's let Lorenzo get his artwork on and show the exciting conclusion of this epic battle. Octopus man fighting sushi. This has to be the coolest thing ever. Okay, well,
we're gonna actually do this comic book now, Dan.
Yeah, we actually do have to do this comic book.
Remember this.
Oh, trust me, I you know what my force somehow. Be like a nickel for everybody. Yes, and okay, so guys, well, this is actually a cool brainstorming session. And this actually is really one of the ways we kick around ideas and try to figure things out. Normally, what normally happens is that we'll hand the concept over to a writer, and the writer will actually come up with all of this insanity in a moment. Sometimes we tone down, depending on the writer, sometimes it can be way more. I'm like, oh, that was good stuff today. Okay, cool. Look at that.
Stop it. Well, you popped his toes.
Yeah, you popped his toes.
Just to make him a little more.
Yeah, you gotta put the eyelash around his eyes.
He's the eval. In case no one knows that he's in the bag.
Right, well, he's a toaster. Okay, so while Lorenzo continues drawing the epic conclusion, any questions, comments from the crowd? Anybody? Well, you know what? Let's ask this. Anybody in here a comics creator that actually has their own comics? Okay, there you go. Anybody ever thought about creating comics? Okay, cool. Let's see. Filmmakers. We have filmmakers in here. All right. And then I had to have a question for you guys. How come you haven't considered comics? Okay. Now that could slow you down, but you know, there's people that do really good things with stick figures. So one of the reasons why I brought that up is that comics is one of those visual mediums that you can actually tell any story through, whether it's your big budget motion picture, your rom-com, drama. You can touch on serious subjects. Comics are dealing with everything from the Holocaust up to just pure comedy, just that whole spectrum. So what we want you guys, what we hope and what we love for people to do is to actually consider the visual medium of comics as an outlet for your ideas before you move on to bigger and better things, or if you're just that type of person, that storyteller, that may be just your way. And you don't have to, you know, put it up. You don't have to print it or anything like that. You put it up a web, all of those types of things. Wow. Explosive. And after this big battle scene is completed, we do have to have a happily ever after scene. So how do we want to end our comic book?
They all eat donuts.
They all get donuts. Well, except for Toaster. I don't think I don't think he's going to be eating any donuts anytime soon. And he ate Susie Man's head, so.
What about just an epic high five shot of the heroes?
Frozen high five?
The Super Friends high five.
Yes, the Super Friends high five. The epic Frozen high five. I think that is the best way to go.
So what did this 8-year-old?
Oh, all right.
Well, it started with a toilet.
Yes.
The character was almost like Toilet Man.
It was Toilet Man.
So I had to draw a toilet and put a face on a toilet. And it was, yeah. And the bad guy was, well, number two. So you can imagine how that all went.
There's an emoji that kind of looks like our bad guy.
Yes.
That the 8-year-olds came up with. And how did their story end? It was quite
explosive.
it didn't end well, from what I understand. Well, I guess for our toilet superhero, it ended well, but not for our emoji guy. That's what we'll call emoji guy.
Yeah.
So, in comparison to what the 8-year-olds came up with, how do you guys think you did?
Pretty awesome.
Yeah,
pretty awesome, huh?
Thank you.
We're not talking about you. Okay.
It's not about you.
I know.
Here we go.
Make sure
it's a,
Too funny, but she said the high five.
Yes,
yeah,
it's
gotta
be the high five.
Give me a high five.
Yes, ma'am. You know what? I think that's a good way for the end of the story with Sushi Man drawing a donut head and living out his true life.
Much better.
Because, you know.
You really gotta be yourself.
Yeah, you gotta be yourself. You can't be anybody else. That's just not gonna work. Sushi donuts in his tentacles.
They're coming.
Oh, he's taking a
light
break.
He's kind of hoarding the donuts.
Well, you know, he likes his donuts. So. This is what we call
strange donuts. Why buy this? As a all those little things make all those little donuts to strange donuts.
Right. So as Lorenzo finishes up. Well, basically, this is how we present to the crowds. We talk to you guys, we get you involved, we get your ideas, we make it look good for you. So, you kind of feel, and you get a feel for just that creative process. So, one last time, questions, comments, more comments than questions.
How do we get a hold of you or see more of this type of work or see you guys again?
Let's see. We're working on more presentations, right?
Yes.
So we're going to be doing more fun presentations like this. We also are looking into doing summer camps for kids. We're also available on social media. If you just put in DKG72, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, you'll find me. If you put in
Lorenzo Lozana, Lozana Art on Instagram, Lozana Art, which is my last name. L-I-Z-A-N-A-A-R-T.
He just totally fucked it. Yeah, that was a beautiful handoff and he just fumbled.
That's what happens. I only worked with the pen, not the tongue.
Ah, my goodness. This is totally fucked. So, also, for Lion Force Comics, if you go to lionforce.com, you'll see the website and all this glory. Comics are also available on Comixology. Lorenzo, don't you have some creative own stuff that you're doing as well, sir?
Why, yes I am. I'm working on my first comic book with my creator own character called Scary, and that'll be out later this year. He's a modern day, well, he's actually a St. Louis based surveyor. So that was kind of St. Louis.
And I'm working on my own creative my own book, Kwame Hightower and the Man with No Name, where it's Adventures of a 13-year-old boy who gets to become the King of England, and the adventures that follow. So that will also be out later on this year. So, got a lot of stuff going on. Oh, wow, he gets a new body and everything.
Well, I felt bad for Sushi Chef.
So is that how it works now? Like, you can get your head bit off by an octopus, man, and then you just grow a new head and get a new body? That might be a good weight loss plan. I might have to try that.
It's
called
rehab.
It's called
rehab.
Can you put your website up there and write it out?
Sure. So let's write out the website for the Lion Forge. And also all our socials.
Okay. And it was by us. .com, right?
Yes, .com.
Yours?
EKG72. That works for YouTube, Twitter, and Instagram. Just put that.
There we go. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, he didn't rehearse this.
That's
super. There we go. All right. So here it is for everybody to see. Lionforge.com for all the comic books. And we have over 70 titles coming out this year. We also have titles that are imported from Europe, coming from France, and France is Europe, sorry.
Under our magnet press
in Japan. We also have our new Catalyst Prime Superhero Universe, which will be launching in May on Free Comic Book Day. So yes, definitely check that out.
Follow the adventures of Voltron from the Netflix show. We do the original comic book based on the Netflix show as well.
Anybody in the mermaids? Because we have this cool book called Mer. That's out on Lion Forge. It just came out, Mer. So if you're in the mermaids, check that out, definitely. And of course, if you want to talk to us, it's up on Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube at the following. That is such a ugly ad. That's really buggy.
It's because the toaster guy did that too.
The toaster guy did
that. He messed it up, yeah.
Oh, you want to write my name?
Yeah.
And you want to put your name on it too, so you know people. Yeah. You know. No, I have to check these things out.
There we go.
All right, so ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our presentation. I hope you enjoyed it.
And this has been a lot more smoother than the children, so you know.
Yeah, so I think you guys did top the 8
minutes. Yeah.
I need my $5.
Thanks so much. Great job, guys. Awesome. Another round of applause.